Hello friends, actually we are receiving so many queries regarding the issues faced by so many people who are presently migrating their existing registration numbers to GST platform. So in the first session I am planning to take about the practical issues in the GST migration. So what are the issues we are normally facing is, the first one is the digital signature problem. You are not able to verify your GST form with digital signature. So what are the configuration you have to be updated with your system to enable the digital signature? So first you have to download the file EM signer, which is available under your My Register or Update DSC column under your login. That the latest version is 1.2, which is available in the GST site. You have to install it, and after installing you have to restart your system once. So after restarting the system, you have to check with your Java version. Presently the Java version latest is 8.1.31 is available. Some of the people are able to do with lower version also. Presently I am doing with 8.1.31 only. And also the prescribed browser for updating your DSE or signing with DSE is Internet Explorer. So you have to be checked with that your Internet Explorer version should be 11. Minimum 11. So many people are using Windows Explorer 10 or 8, that they cannot able to see the GST page itself, not properly they cannot able to log in also. So you have to check with three points. First, you have to download your EM signer and install it, and second point, you have to check with your Java version, and third point is you have to use the Internet Explorer, which is best for to update your migration of GST. So after installing this, and you have to restart your system and open Internet Explorer, and then log in with your provisional ID and password, fill up your all details, and first before signing with the e-digital signature, you have to register and update your signature, and that you can find your the authorized signatory name, and you can select it and update your digital signature. So what if you find fail to establish connection or error? In that case, you have to check that EM signer service has been started or not. In most of the cases, in the EM signer icon will be available under the date and time place. Next to the date and time, you can able to see EM signer option. So if you have to double click and you have to open it, if you are able to see the EM signer is started successfully, you can just hide it and you can go for signing. If it's stating some error, you have to stop service and you have to start the EM signer. Right click the EM signer icon and start it as administrator. So try with the administrator option so that you can able to see, you can able to sign the document. So what if I have signed my GST application, I have signed my GST application, and most of the cases the ARN will be generated within 15 minutes. In some cases it will take some hours also. So after some of the, in many people facing that, there is some validation error. After filing that, they can able to find out that validation error under the My Saved Application column. So what are the reasons mainly due to which the validation error can happen? So one of the main reason is the person verifying the GST application, the name as per PAN may be mismatched. So how you should give your name as per PAN under the GST law, in the GST form. So you need to find out the what is the first name as per PAN and last name as per PAN, as well as the first name and last name of fathers provided in the PAN to fill in the authorized signatory digital in the details. So in income tax e-filing side, you can able to see your first name and last name under jurisdictional AO earlier, but the income tax has been removed that option. So what is the shortcut to find out your first name and last name under PAN? So we have found out some shortcut which we are using. So I am going to show that. You can find that in MCA site, Ministry of Corporate Affairs site, under forms and downloads, you can download the form DIR3, which is for DIN application, So you have to open that form. You fill the first name and last name as provided as you have in your PAN card copy or as in available on the income tax site. Also you have to fill the father name and just fill the date of birth column. and date of birth column, and provide the income tax pan number, and verify, click the verify button. You just need to fill these three details: the name of the applicant, father names, and date of birth, and pan details, and verify. If the first name and last name doesn't match with the pan database, the error will be shown. You have to try any other combination: first name, middle name, last name, any other combination which will enable you to show the message that the pan verification is successful. Once the verification is successful, it shows the message verification is successful. You just go to your GST site and provide the name as you have found it here, first name and last name, and sign it again. So you can overcome the validation error by this method. And in some of the cases, even some validation error shown in the MySaved application column, some of the peoples are receiving ARN generated in their respective mail. So before resubmitting your application, just verify with your registered email to whether your ARN is generated or not. So these are some of the practical issues faced by the taxpayers while migrating their GST. So tomorrow is the last date, so be prepared, and if you are finding any issues, feel free to contact us.